Here I am talk about the reproduction of Vaucheria. So reproduction is performed by two types, asexual and sexual. Polysiphonia is heterothele. It exhibits triphasic alteration of generation. Three kinds of thalli are present in the life cycle of polysiphonia. First one is the gametophyte. So the thallus is haploid, free living and dioecious. There are separate male gametophyte which bear the male sex organs spermatangium and female gametophyte which bear the female sex organ carpogonium. Second, the carposporophyte. These are diploid thallus which develops from the zygote. They produce carposporangia which produce diploid carpospores, and the tetrasporophyte formed by the germination of diploid carpospore. It is diploid and produce tetrasporangia which produce haploid tetraspore and which on germination produce male and female gametophyte. The gametophytes are concerned with sexual reproduction, which is oogamous. Polysiphonia is a heterothelic and dioecious. The male sex organ and the female sex organ are born on different gametophytes. Male gametophyte produce male sex organ spermatangium. Female gametophyte produce female sex organ carpogonium. Both male and female gametophytic plants are morphologically similar. Male gametophyte. It bears the male sex organs spermatangia, which are born in dense cluster and are closely packed, forming a compact cone-shaped structure on the upper branch of dichotomously branched male trichoblast. In some species, both the branches of the trichoblast become fertile, and the two basal cells of the trichoblast function as the stalk and other cell cut off pericentral cell. Thus, the fertile portion of these branches become polysiphonous, and the pericentral cells may divide once and twice, producing a large number of spermatangial mother cell, which are arranged in the form of a compact layer external to the central siphon. These figures shows. First one is A, terminal portion of the thallus with antheridia, and B shows a part of the antheridium with spermatangial mother cell and spermatia in longitudinal view. C shows the same in transverse sections and releasing spermatium from spermatangium. So each spermatangial mother cell gives rise to the 2 and 4 spermatangia and antheridia, and the spermatangia are spherical and oblong unicellular structures. So the content of each spermatangium produce a single non-motile spherical male gamete and spermatium. That spermatia are liberated by the formation of narrow slit in the spermatangial wall and are carried by water current to the vicinity of the female sex organ, female gametophyte. So it bears the female sex organ carpogonium, and the female trichoblast initial arise from the central siphon, 3 and 4 cell behind the apical cell, and it divides repeatedly to form a reduced female trichoblast 5 to 7 cells in height. And 3 lowermost cells of the female trichoblast divide vertically to form an sitting layer of pericentral cell, which are arranged in 3 tiers, one above the other. So one of the pericentral cells in the middle tier on the adaxial side becomes the supporting cell, and the lateral cuts off is some initial cell. It's free and known as the procarp initials, and the initial cell divided and redivided to form a small curved 4 cell branch called carpongeal filament, and we can say another name is procarp. So this figure shows the development of carpogonium. The terminal cell of the carpogonial filament function as the carpogonium mother cell, gives gates modified into the carpogonium, and the carpogonium has a basal swollen portion in the which the egg and female gametes is present as a terminal cylinder portion called trichogyne. In the meantime, the supporting cell cuts off 2 style cell and one towards its base and called the basal style filament initial, another on one side called the lateral style filament initial, and the later divide is immediately to form a two-cell lateral strial filament. And this stage is the carpogonium is ready for fertilization. In fertilization, the spermatia liberated from the male gametophytic plant are carried by the water current to the carpogonium. When spermatia adheres to the zygogene of the carpogonium and the point of attachment dissolve and the male nucleus enter into the zygogene. And the male nucleus then enters to the zygogene and moves down, and this is the solen base to the carpogonium and fuse with the female gamete to the form of zygote. It's the formation of zygote represent the end point of the haploid gametophytic generation and the starting point of the diploid carposporophytes. In post-fertilization changes, the post-fertilization changes in polycyphalia include the following events. First one is two-cell lateral strial filament becomes 4 to 10 cell, and the basal strial filament initially divided to form of two-cell filament. The strial filament are nutritive in function, and the supporting cell bursts off an auxiliary cell, its upper hand. It has a haploid nucleus and lies down close to the carpogonium. And the auxiliary cell establish a tubular connection with the base of the carpogonium. And the diploid nucleus of the carpogonium divides mitotically into two daughter nuclei, and one of these nuclei migrated into auxiliary cell through the tubular connection. And the haploid nucleus of the auxiliary cell now degenerated, leaving behind only the diploid nucleus. And the carpogonial branch gradually begin to shrivel. And the outgrowth of the pericentral cell adjacent to the supporting cell start producing an envelope around the developing carposporophyte. Now many initials called gonemoblast initials are produced from the auxiliary cell. The diploid nucleus of the auxiliary cell divides mitotically, and each daughter nucleus migrates into the gonemoblast initial. Thus, each gonemoblast initial contains a diploid nucleus. Each gonemoblast initial divides and redivides to form a short gonemoblast filament. The terminal cell of the gonemoblast filament develops into the elongated pear-shaped carposporangia. And the contents of each pair carposporangia differentiate into a single diploid carpospore. This figure shows the post-fertilization changes of polysiphonia. By this time, the supporting cell auxiliary cell carpogonial filament and the strial filament fuse to form an irregular shaped nutritive cell called placental cell and the carposporophyte or cystocarp. This is the second individual formed in the life cycle of polysiphonia. The whole structure consisting of gonemoblast filament, carposporophyte and carpospores. So, and the placental cell gets completely enveloped by the vegetative filament, which form unshaped walled carp, cystocarpus and corpusphyte. The wall of the cystocarpus is called pericarp and the opening is called osteole. And the cystocarp of the carposporophyte is dependent on the female gametophytic plant, and carpospore are liberated through the osteole and are carried by water current. So, and the third one is tetrasporophyte. The diploid carpospore on germination produce new diploid plant called tetrasporophyte, so which resemble gametophytic plant in morphology. It consists of the central siphon encircled by pericentral siphon. So they produce stake like tetrasporangia, form small size pericentral cell. So that outer cell divides and forms two or more cover cell, whereas the inner cell function as the sporangial mother cell. The sporangial mother cell divides transversely into a lower stalk and upper tetrasporangial wall, and the sporangial cell function as a tetrasporangium, and the diploid nucleus of tetrasporangium divide meiotically to form a 4 haploid nuclei and form a tetraspore. Tetraspore are liberated by the rupturing of sporangial wall. This figure shows of tetrasporophyte of polysiphonia. Polysiphonia, this is a post-fertilization changes. Polysiphonia life cycle, the life cycle of polysiphonia is a triphasic and haplo-diplobiontic. Three different phases in the life cycle. Haploid phase represented by the male and female gametophyte. Diploid phase represented by a carposporophyte cystocarp. Diploid phase represented by a tetrasporophyte. At a haploid phase, the gametophytic reproduce sexually and male gametophyte produce spermatangia, which produce the non-motile male gamete spermatia. And the